Hello my dear students, welcome to my channel Learning Hub. So in my previous video I covered relational operators. In this video I will be covering logical operators, chain comparison operators and bitwise operators. So logical operators are further divided into AND, OR and NOT. So what are logical operators? Basically logical operators are those operators that deals with truth values. Means whenever we are using logical operator, it result in either true value or false value. Truth value means either true or false. So the very first operator, first of all I'll tell you what are these truth values, how AND is evaluated. The very first operator is AND operator. Now suppose we take a condition ki if I go to market, I want to buy orange. So my parents have told me ki buy orange only if it is sweet and it is bigger in size. So they gave me two conditions. If both the conditions are there, then only you should buy oranges. So similarly, if I'll talk about AND operator, it works, it gives true value only when both the conditions are true. Both the condition, yeah, all the conditions are true, then only it will result in true value. For example, suppose condition 1, if AND operator is dealing with two operands, condition 2, if and what will be the output? If both the conditions are false, then output will be false. If one condition is false and another one is true, the output will be false. If first condition is true, another one is false, the output will be false. If both the conditions are true, then only output is true. So if we take the same example of orange, if orange is neither sweet nor bigger in size, don't buy an orange, means output is false. If orange is not sweet but it is bigger in size, here both the conditions are not matching, then also don't buy orange, it means output is false. If orange is sweet but it is not bigger in size, so output is false, means don't buy oranges. If orange is sweet, this was the condition given by my parents, that orange is sweet and orange is bigger in size, then buy orange, means this is. So in short, the AND operators result in true value only when both the conditions are true. Now comes OR operator. OR operator, if we talk about the same example, if my parents tell me, just check, if oranges are sweet, then you can buy, or if oranges are bigger in size, then also you can buy orange. Means any one condition is true, then also we can buy orange. So if both the condition are false, then only output is false. Otherwise, if one condition is true, then output is true. Now next operator is NOT operator. It basically deals with one operand, means only one condition is given. If input is true, it will return false. If input is false, it will return true. Means it inverse it. So if input is true, output is false. And if output is false, sorry, input is false, output is true. Now how all these operators are implemented? Suppose I give a condition print, the very first is AND operator. Print x is 2 is less than 3 and 2 is greater than 1. So in this condition, 2 is less than 3. It will evaluate true. It will evaluate and return true. 2 is greater than 1. Yes, it is greater than 1. If both the conditions are true, so output will be true. So what will be printed? True will be printed. Suppose I have written here 2 is greater than 3. So 2 is greater than 3? No. So it will return in false. 2 is greater than 1? Yes. So it will return in true. In this case, as soon as first condition is false, it will not evaluate the last condition and directly it will go to, directly it will print false. You must know about, you must have heard about divide by zero error. Means if we are trying to divide any number by zero, so it will result in infinite. And in Python, when we will try to print it, so it will generate an error, that is divide by zero error. So suppose I have written here, 2 is greater than 3 divided by 0. In this case, first this 3 divided by 0 is evaluated and then only comparison can be done. So logically if we think, so it should generate an error. But it will not generate error, it will simply print false. How? Because first of all it will check first condition. First condition is false. So it will not go to second condition, because AND operator check if any one condition is false, then output is false. So it will not go to second condition and directly it will print false. Now next operator, now chained operators, chain comparison operator. How it works? Suppose I have written here 2 greater than 3 greater than 5. This is chained operators. So it can be also written as 2 is greater than 3 and 3 is greater than 5. So we are breaking this chain comparison in this type of comparison using logical operator. Or suppose I have written 2 is greater than 3 less than 5. It can be written as 2 is greater than 3 and 3 is less than 5. These are chain comparison operators. Next comes bitwise operator. Now bitwise operators are same as logical operators, but it deals with the smaller values. Means basically it deals with the binary values of any number. Now what are binary values? Each and every number has a binary value associated with it. So if you know about the conversion, I'll tell you about the simple conversion, how number is converted into binary form. Suppose I have a number 12. So we will divide the number by 2, 2 6 is 12 and remainder is 0. 2 3 is 6, remainder is 0. 2 1 is 2, remainder is 1. 2 0 is 0, remainder is 1. In this way we will divide and write in bottom up approach. So equivalent of by decimal number 12 is 1 1 0 0 binary number. So in this way system converts any number to binary number. So bitwise operator basically deals with binary numbers. Suppose I have written here, the very first operator is AND operator, which is similar to logical operator AND. Suppose I have written here 12 and 30. So equivalent of 12 is 13 is 13 is this. So it will compare bit by bit. 1 and 1 means 1 is true, 1 means true value, 0 means false value. Both the values are true, the output is true. Both the values are true, output is true. Both the values are false, output is false. 1 is false and another 1 is true, output is false. So this is equivalent to 12. So if we are trying to print this, so 12 will be printed. Similarly, if we are using OR operator is denoted by bitwise operator, OR is denoted by pipe sign. So in this case it will check both the values, and if any one value is true then it will return true. It will first check first two. Both are true, output is true. Second, both are true, output is true. Third, both are false, output is false. One is false, another one is true. So output is true. So in this case, it will print 30. Next operator is bitwise XOR operator. XOR operator basically it returns true only when one is true, another one is false. Means both the condition are inverse of each other. So for example, suppose condition 1 and condition 2. If this is true, this is true, output will be false. If this is false, this is true, output is true. If this is true, this is false, output is true. If this is false and this is false, output is false. Means when both the inputs are inverse of each other, then only output is false. So XOR is represented by this exponent symbol. So it will check both the values, 1 and 1. Both are same, so output is 0. It will check both the values. Both are same, output is 0. Again, both are same, output is 0. 1 is 0, another 1 is 1, means both are inverse of each other. Output is 1. And this is equivalent of 1 decimal number. So what it will print? In this case, 1 will be printed. Output will be 1. The last operator is complement operator. Complement operator basically deals with only one operand. Means if we are writing complement of 12. In this case, complement, the symbol is tilde sign. So the equivalent binary value of 12 is this. So what it will return? It will inverse the digit. Complement means if it is 0, it will convert it into 1. If it is 1, it will convert it into 0. So now I will quickly demonstrate this on my laptop.
So my dear students, this is the program which I have written for you to demonstrate the use of logical operator. The first two lines shows relational operator, which I have already explained. Here it is checking whether 3 is greater than 5 or not. Because it is not greater than 5, so it will print false. I am running this program. You can see the first line, 3 is greater than 5, so it will print false. The second line, 8 is greater than 5. Yes, 8 is greater than 5, so it will print 2. Now I have used this relational operator along with logical operator. So when we are using AND, so it has to check both the conditions. Means the first condition is 3 is greater than 5. No. When the first condition is false, it will not check the second condition. Directly it will print false because it is not needed at all. Now come to next line. If 5 is greater than 2, in this case it is greater. So when we are using OR, if either condition is true, then the output is true. So first condition is true, then second condition is not checked. Now you can see the second condition, logically it should display an error, divide by 0 error, because I have used this 5 divided by 0. But in this case, why it is not displaying error? Because the first condition is true, so it is not going to the second condition. So I'll change this OR with AND. If I'm using AND, in that case, I'll show you it will generate an error. Here I will change it. I'll make it AND. Here also in string, I am changing it so that you can understand easily. So I'm running this program. See, it will generate error because in AND, both the conditions are to be checked. So when it is checking second condition, it will display error. So it means that in AND, it will check both the condition, but in OR, it will check first condition. If it is false, then it will check second condition. Now, next statement is not 5. I will run this program. Not 5 means 5 is not 0. So, value of 5 is true. value of 5 is true because it is not a zero value, and that this is inverted by not. Not will invert the true value to false value. Next operator is bitwise AND operator. This I have already explained on the board that 12, the value of 12 and value of 13 will be converted into binary numbers and it will display 12. Similarly, I explained by bitwise OR also and bitwise XOR also. You can just rewind the video and see how you can get these three outputs. Now the next one is complement. Complement means this will be converted to binary number, and binary number means it will be 1100, but binary, because it is of 8 bit, first it will be converted to 8 bit binary number and then complemented. Therefore, because it is a 2's complement, it will be converted to 2's complement. That is why minus 13 will be printed.
So my dear students, I hope you understood this concept. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe and hit the bell icon. Thank you and have a nice day.